Good day to all of you. Myself Dr. Arvind Sharma, Associate Professor in Physics, Government Dugar College, Bikaner. Today's topic of discussion is stationary perturbation theory for degenerate case. In last few lectures, we understand about the non-degenerate case perturbation, stationary perturbation theory and their applications. Now in this lecture, we try to understand about the stationary perturbation theory for degenerate case. In the preceding discussion, we have assumed that there is one eigenfunction for one eigenvalue and have found for the first order correction to be function h. In last lectures, we already derived for non-degenerate case where only one eigenfunction belongs to one eigenvalue, and the results we derive psi k dash equal to summation al psi l 0 and al equal to bra l h dash k m upon em 0 minus el 0. This causes difficulty if two states correspond to same energy. That means if energy eigenvalues are degenerate, and we are taking the case where two states psi l0 and psi m0 correspond to same energies em0 equal to el0. Unless bra l h dash k m equal to 0. As bra l h dash k m is not equal to 0, the results obtained for non-degenerate case would not be applicable to such cases. If actual physical situations there are systems in which a number of orthogonal eigenfunctions correspond to the same eigenvalue, we know that if there are number of orthogonal eigenfunctions corresponding to same eigenvalue, such systems are called degenerate case. And we know that the degree of degeneracy is the number of independent eigenstates corresponding to same eigenvalue. In such case, the perturbation method is as follows. We are taking now case for degenerate case. Let us consider two eigenstates. And the two eigenstates are psi 1 0 and psi 2 0. And these are having same eigenvalues in unperturbed system. That means E10 equal to E20 equal to E0. Okay. And we know that for different eigenfunctions, you can take the Schrodinger equation for unperturbed case H0 psi10 equal to E0 psi10 and H0 psi20 equal to E0 psi20. As eigenfunctions, which is linear combination of these two eigenfunctions, will also corresponding to this energy. We know according to superposition principle, if there are two eigenfunctions and their linear combination is also eigenfunctions corresponding to this energy, then we are taking the case of superposition psi 0 equal to alpha 1 psi 1 0 plus alpha 2 psi 2 0. Hence, psi h 0 psi 0 equal to h 0 alpha 1 psi 1 0 plus alpha 2 psi 2 0. And this becomes e 0 alpha 1 psi 1 0 alpha 2 plus alpha 2 psi 2 0. And we are taking the similar case as we start simple Schrodinger equation. Hence, psi 0 is also, that is, this is the function that is also corresponding to the this energy. Using orthonormal properties of psi 1 0 and psi 2 0, we have alpha 1 star, alpha 1 plus alpha 2 star, alpha 2 equal to 1. Orthonormal property if we are taking only two eigenfunctions. there may be an infinite number of eigenfunctions. There are infinite number of eigenfunctions which may be built out of these two eigenfunctions corresponding to the same eigenvalue is 2. Such a set of n functions is linearly independent. Such a n functions is linearly independent if there exist no relation in the form. If they are linearly independent, then such kind of relation is non-existent. That means no relation of such kind of exist for these functions. That means alpha 1 psi 1 0 plus alpha 2 psi 2 0 plus dash dash plus alpha n psi n 0 equal to 0. If there are n linearly independent eigenfunctions, suppose we are taking n linearly independent eigenfunctions corresponding to the same eigenvalue, the state is said to be n-fold descendant. If there are n linearly independent eigenfunctions, then these are known as n-fold degenerate. We know the number of degeneracy is equal to the number of linearly independent eigenfunctions. And an other function possessing the same energy can be expressed as psi 0 equal to alpha 1 psi 1 0 plus alpha 2 psi 2 0 plus alpha n psi n 0. From the normalization condition of size, we get alpha 1 star alpha 1 plus alpha 2 star alpha 2 plus alpha n star alpha n equal to. Let us now consider the perturbed system. Suppose we are now taking the case of perturbation. That is perturbed system. Then Schrodinger equation is Si equal to E psi. And Hamiltonian is also perturbed up to first order. H equal to H0 plus lambda H dash. Hence equation becomes H0 plus lambda H dash Psi equal to E psi. So this is the equation for Schrodinger equation for perturbed case. For lambda tending to 0, the system tends to unperturbed state, and let this case the system be as follows. Suppose if we are taking the lambda tending to 0 and the system tends to unperturbed state, and suppose that unperturbed state is as follows. Degenerate, S-fold degenerate. At lambda tending to 0, the system tends to unperturbed state, and the system we are taking is S-fold degenerate. Then the unperturbed Schrodinger equation at 0 psi 0 equal to E0 psi 0 has the solutions, because we are taking the S-fold degeneracy. Hence the solutions have from psi 11 to psi 1s. From psi 11 to psi 1s. Psi 110, psi 120, psi 130 up to psi 1s0. Similarly, psi 2s0, psi 220 to psi 2s0. And psi k10, psi k20 up to psi ks0. And corresponding eigenvalues are E1, 0, E20, EK0 respectively. Let psi k10, psi k20 up to psi ks0. We are taking the case as fold degenerate represents some arbitrary chosen orthonormal set of eigenfunctions. Suppose they represent some orthonormal set of eigenfunctions which we are choosing arbitrarily. The problem in degenerate system is to find the set of unperturbed wave functions. What is the problem? You first find the set of unperturbed wave functions to which perturbed functions reduce when the perturbation vanishes. This is very important point. For degenerate case, what you do, you just find the set of unperturbed functions. You just find the set of unperturbed wave functions to which perturbed functions reduce when the perturbation vanishes. The evaluation of coefficient in the linear combination converting the initial chosen wave function into correct zeroth order wave functions. Okay, let the correct eigenfunction in zero approximation be represented by linear combination. In zero approximation, correct eigenfunction is psi k0 equal to summation l equal to s to s alpha kl psi kl0. You just see this expression. Psi k0 equal to summation l equal to 1 to s alpha kl psi kl. This is the case, or this is the wave function we are taking to understand the degenerate case. Okay. Now, the eigenvalue and eigenfunctions of perturbed system. For perturbed system, we know that the eigenvalues Ek equal to Ek0 plus lambda Ek dash plus lambda square Ek double dash. Simple, like as we start for non-degenerate case, the expressions are similar. But wave functions are psi k equal to psi k 0 plus lambda psi k dash plus lambda square psi k dash and so on. That means Ek and psi k are the same expressions as we do at the start of this chapter for non-degenerate case. Now for degenerate case, you just replace psi k 0. Here psi k 0 is replaced by this wave function, because perturbed wave functions, what we do? We find for degenerate case the set of unperturbed wave functions to which the perturbed wave functions reduce when perturbation vanishes. For this case, we are taking this wave function, and this is the key factor to solve the problem for degenerate case. Okay. Now just replace these values in equation 8, and we get, using equation 10, equation becomes H0, H psi equal to, this is H, this is psi, this is E, and this is psi. Fundamentally same, H0 plus lambda S dash, this is H, summation alpha kl psi kl 0 plus alpha psi k dash plus alpha square psi k double dash equal to ek 0 plus lambda ek dash plus lambda square ek double dash. This is E, and again the same psi, this is the psi, and this is the same wave function is E. That is S psi equal to E psi for perturbation case. Equating coefficients of like powers. If we now equate the both sides for like powers of lambda. Okay. This is equation. Suppose this is the part for lambda 0. That means coefficient of lambda 0. And this is equation is given by, if we are taking the case for lambda 0. That means H0, this term, and this term, okay, H0, and this, and Ek0, and this function. This is the coefficient corresponding to lambda. H0, summation alpha kl psi kl0 equal to Ek0, summation alpha kl psi kl0. And for coefficient lambda dash, the equation becomes, you just see from here, H0 multiplied by this term. Okay. And Ek0 multiplied by this term. So this part becomes on left hand side, H0 minus Ek0 psi k dash equal to alpha KL Ek dash from here, and S dash from here. Ek dash minus S dash psi k dash. So we can equate for coefficient of lambda, and we can easily get these equations by computing the like power of lambda. Okay, so this is the process to start degenerate case to simplify the equations. So try to understand these equations. In next video, we just try to calculate the results if for non-degenerate case perturbation is small and perturbed system is very near to the unperturbed system. Okay. So just try to understand these mathematical aspects. Okay. Thanks to all of you.